Hey, what's up, Crypto Army? I'm Travis, your crypto newbie, bringing you my experiences you have to learn things the hard way. Just a reminder, I'm not a financial advisor, and none of my content should be viewed as financial advice. If you like what my content offers, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Like the video and turn on notifications so you get notified when I post new content. It really helps the channel grow and get this content out to others that might find it interesting. Now, just a quick ad before we jump into the contents of today's video. Crypto Newbie here to tell you how you can get $2,340 in free stocks. All the links I use in this video are in the description. Sign up for Webull and get two free stocks valued up to $2,300. Your first stock is free automatically. Deposit any amount and you get your second stock. Deposit one penny and you get your second stock. Total value could be up to $2,300. Generally, $5 per stock is what you get. Next, we have BlockFi. Get $10 in Bitcoin just for signing up. But read the fine print. I've got a rewards account. You'll get $40 in Bitcoin, as will I. So you know exactly what I'm going to get and what you're going to get. You need to deposit $100 to get your $40 in Bitcoin. That's the overview how to get $2,340 just by signing up for accounts. Today we're going to do just a quick update on LFZero. They've got a recent blog entry that we're going to cover talking about a partnership with the Dominican Republic. There hasn't been a lot of other news to really talk to, so I'm just going to cover that specific blog post. Now, this is their main website. To see this blog, all you would do is go to learn and go to the blog, and then it'll pull right up. Again, I will put the actual direct link to the blog post in the description of this video, along with any of the links that I look at. Now, a lot of blockchains are trying to do partnerships with other countries to get blockchain technology adopted by more countries throughout the world, as well as build up the cost. Obviously, more users is better. And LFZero is just like everybody else is trying to do the same thing. SafeMoon is trying to do the same thing in the Gambia. Cardano is trying to do the same thing in Africa, Ethiopia, I believe. So this is kind of a common thing, and it's good. It's good for the blockchain, and it's good for the country when we do these partnerships, and it builds up those use cases for the adoption of the blockchain globally as well. Because if it works in one country, it's likely to work in a different country. And the US is usually a little bit behind on these types of changes, and seeing it work in another country might motivate the US to adopt blockchain technology as well. So why does LFZero as a blockchain make sense for the Dominican Republic? And one of the dominating features is the low cost proposition that you get from LFZero. With a near zero transaction cost, LFZero is ideally suited for a lot of different developing nations to adopt. Now, the low cost transactions specifically make it a great option for the Dominican Republic, but there's a lot of reasons why the Dominican Republic would benefit from this as well, and we're going to cover those a little bit here through this video. So before we get too far into it, we'll scroll down a little bit because we've been looking at this screen for a little while, but let's cover some stuff about the Dominican Republic you should consider when you consider the partnership between LF and them. The Dominican Republic has a population of approximately 10.8 million people, so that's potentially 10.8 million users of LFZero's blockchain if they can work out a partnership with the Dominican Republic. Its total GDP is somewhere in the vicinity of $82 billion. It was actually a little bit higher in 2019, but COVID, as we all have issues with COVID, had a reduction in their GDP in 2020 and now into 2021 as well. It's the 10th largest economy in Latin America and the largest of the Caribbean region. It's a middle income country. The economy is based on tourism as one of the central tourist locations in the region. Agriculture, it's a free trade zone for manufacturing, mining, real estate, and service industry. There's a lot going on in the Dominican Republic that makes it a good candidate for partnering with LFZero. And in each of those areas, LFZero's blockchain technology can provide benefits. And really, those are some of the things that are called out in this blog post. So we look at the analysis that LFZero's team did, and they called into some of those things as well. So it's one of the favorite destinations in the Caribbean for investors from abroad, strong trade partnerships, especially with the US, and some of the challenges that they've got there as well. And then we start getting into some of the institutional inefficiencies slowing their innovation and their development. Now, in recent years, international indicators of the Dominican Republic's competitiveness and transparency continue to erode. Foreign investors cite a lack of clear, standardized rules by which to compete, and they lack enforcement on existing rules not too far from a lot of countries, but I think it's to a different kind of an extent in the Dominican Republic. Complaints include allegations of widespread corruption, requests for bribes, delays in government payouts, weak intellectual property rights enforcement, bureaucratic hurdles, slow and sometimes biased judicial processes, non-standard procedures and customs and valuation of their imported goods, as well as product misclassifications as a means of negating some of the trade agreements that they have, specifically the CAFTA-Dominican Republic agreement. They also have weak land tenure laws, and government expropriations continue to be a problem. Now, their energy sector is also something that they're looking into developing. It's one of the things that most of the global economies are trying to tackle, is how to deal with the energy sector, specifically renewable energies. Now, one of the specific things that the 11-0 team call out are the tax evasion issues. And that's one of the great benefits of a blockchain, is it's very transparent when it's used correctly. Now, 11-0 does have a privacy layer built in, but there's some benefits to having the transparency layer, so it's really hard to evade your taxes. But there's some other issues inside of the Dominican Republic that make that a barrier to entry, and we'll cover that here in a second. So let's continue to scroll down a little bit here, and we can start to see some of the 11-0 team's determinations of whether they make a good fit for the Dominican Republic. And they call the energy market specifically, but everybody's trying to get into the energy market. So all of the blockchains really do add benefit for the energy market, not just a specific one. Where 11-0's real benefits come into play are the low cost and the incredible speed of their transactions. Those two things coupled together make it a great pairing for any country. Now, one of the things that the 11-0 team did identify is switching over to this technological innovation could assist individuals in becoming more in control of their energy consumption. It will also allow those who produce energy to sell their energy on the open market. This use case for blockchain technology will result in smarter energy consumption and also incentivize green energy solutions. And I completely agree. And that's where I really see the benefit of blockchain technology entering into the energy market. There's a lot of benefits. Imagine not having to wait for your energy bill to see what the damage is, where you can pull, because blockchains, especially public blockchains, anybody can access it. And anybody can build a way to integrate the data so that you can see it. And it applies for tax systems, it applies for the energy market, obviously, but pretty much anything. Any kind of a utility system could adopt blockchain technology for complete transparency to the customer. You can see how much you're using, and you can make different choices based off of that. It's a great idea. I hate having to wait for my bill. Now you can buy monitors, and you can install monitors for different things, but if there's a way to integrate it with blockchain technology so you don't need to have those hardware equipment and you can just do everything through a software base, you can pull it up on your phone, that's the ideal solution. Now let's keep going, because there's more than just the energy market. Now I've already kind of talked about the tax system, but I want to emphasize a couple things here, the way that 11-0 looks at the tax system integration. By design, blockchain records every transaction on the network. This makes it ideal for applying the correct taxation to any transfer of goods. Moreover, the MPC-based technology, it's possible to give all parties control over the calculation, but prevent a single party from accessing the information. Introducing these solutions will result in transparent, provable calculations. A benefit for citizens is a transparent record of public finances. Filling out complex tax forms can also be simplified through the adoption of secure blockchain-based services. I've been complaining about this for years, that you've got a blockchain and you can run, especially now that we've got smart contracts, you can run smart contracts or servers, basically software, on the blockchain that can record all the transactions for you and then give you all the information you need for the taxes. It just makes sense. And I'm glad that 11-0 is looking at how to address taxation issues, because every country on the planet has this particular issue, to include the US. It would just be easier to use the blockchain to record back. Now, here's the problem I see. What about multiple blockchains? Now, I know that for the Dominican Republic, they're looking at it, trying to do a single use, but the reality is that every blockchain is going to compete for people's business. Just because they're looking at the Dominican Republic doesn't mean that Solana is not doing it or Cardano is not doing it. There are competitors that are also trying to get in this market, so there's a good chance that people in the Dominican Republic are using other blockchain technologies already. And what about recording those tax transactions? And that's where I see there's a potential issue. And I use multiple blockchains myself, between Ethereum and Binance and potentially 11-0 and Solana. That's one of the challenges I face as well, which is why I have to use a software that I manually or link to. And I suspect that they would build a software suite similar, where you can import from other blockchains. That way you've got the transparency, but you can see the benefit in a country adopting a Left Zero for its blockchain technology. Because if everybody's using blockchain technology at point of sale, or and it gets recorded and you can take a look at it, it's very hard to lie on your taxes, especially from a business perspective, because it's all there. And maybe the government's got a higher level of privileges than the business. You know, the business can see all the business-related transactions, the government can see it as well, and then they can match what's being recorded. And this resolves the transparency issue in the Dominican Republic. What is the barrier, though? And this applies to a lot of the technologies. Full transparency makes it really hard to be a cheat, and the Dominican Republic has an issue with corruption. So if it may not be viewed as a selling point that you can no longer be corrupt. And if you've got government corruption, the barrier to adoption, if the people that are in control of adopting it are also corrupt, not to say that everybody in the Dominican Republic is corrupt, but there is corruption in every government and every business in existence to some degree. There's nobody. Now, there are some good businesses and some good governments out there, but there's always somebody. There's always that one that ruins it for everybody else. And that one, or however many they have, will be a barrier to entrance for a Left Zero, especially since there's quite a few reports that identify there's a lot of corruption in the Dominican Republic. I'm not just pulling that out of thin air. So I see that being a potential issue they're going to have to work through. But let's keep going. We're almost to the end of this article. So potentially one big issue is the banks. Now, the only legal currency based on the Constitution in the Dominican Republic is the currency of the Dominican Republic. So you can't use Left Zero as a currency. And in this particular paper, they're not necessarily talking about doing that. They're talking about some other things that you can do with blockchain, not necessarily the value aspect or using Left Zero as a currency as some other blockchains and some other cryptos are trying to do. But for the Dominican Republic, you run into the problem where they've actually looked at blockchains and cryptocurrencies, and the government came to the conclusion, and more specifically, the Monetary Board and the Central Bank of the Dominican Republic have stated that financial institutions are not allowed to invest or perform operations using virtual currency. And again, that's not necessarily where Left Zero is coming from, but it's a consideration, especially as an investor, that it may never be possible for Left Zero to be used in that capacity. That doesn't prevent people from buying it and from doing other things with it, but you may have some issues with using Left Zero in that capacity in the Dominican Republic. And I think that as an investor, you should know that. Now, where did I get this information for the currency issue? And it's really from here. I was looking at this. Now, unfortunately, I couldn't find it in English, but I did use Google Translate to help me figure it out. And this paragraph right here kind of lays that part out. So if you can read this, then that's where the information is at. And I will put this link in the description. And if you want to go read it for yourself, Google Translate's a great way to do it. Unfortunately, it's a PDF, so it's not going to translate the entire page for you, but you can just copy and paste it in there, and it will translate this for you. And it's essentially saying what I just said, is that they can't use it as a currency because the Constitution prevents using it as a currency. Not to say that they couldn't change the Constitution to make it work with this, but I suspect that's not going to happen. So that's pretty much the update for Left Zero for today. Hopefully you found this content helpful. I will review the comments, so make sure to leave any suggestions, requests, or questions you may have in there. Just a reminder, if you found my content helpful, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, like the video, and turn on notifications so you get notified when I post more content. It really does help the channel grow and get the content to other viewers that might find it interesting. Until next time, stay strong with those diamond hands.